Hey, my name is Lance. This Catapult project is a perfect example of what a class one lever is. So it's a great way to explore the concepts of things like leverage and fulcrums. So let's get started. So first, you'll need to cut two craft sticks in half to get four of these half pieces. You can snap them with a pair of pliers, or you can buy a utility cutter and just cut them in half. Next, start the base of the catapult by gluing craft sticks into a rectangle like this, and then gluing cubes onto each corner. Then after that, what you'll do is glue on another rectangle on top of those cubes. And this structure of layering cubes in between craft sticks will make the base really sturdy. Now we're going to build the sides of the catapult that are going to hold the hinge in a moment. And these are created by gluing two craft sticks onto the side from the cubes and then attaching to each other on the top. And repeat on the other side. Next, start the hinge by gluing two cubes with holes to the tops of the side supports. Now set this aside and we're gonna build the catapult arm next. Put some glue on half of a craft stick and overlap another stick so that about half of the stick is overlapping the first one. Then glue on another stick so that there are two sticks that are end to end with one stick connecting them. Repeat one more time. Then glue two regular cubes onto the ends of the catapult arm, here and here. Then glue on one more cube with a hole in it so that it's lined up with this stick that's being used to connect the other two sticks. Or another way of thinking about it is that this is about a quarter of the way from the end of the catapult arm. Next, glue the other beam on top of those cubes. Get a dowel and estimate the length that it needs to be to fit inside these two cubes with holes at the top, and then cut or break it. Fit the dowel piece into the catapult arm cube, then pry the sides of the catapult apart a little bit and slip the ends of the dowel into the catapult frame. Okay, almost done. The next step is to glue a whole craft stick to the underside of the short end of the arm. This is going to prevent the catapult arm from flipping all the way forward, and instead it'll stop it short right here, which is going to help launch the projectile. Make sure to glue it to the underside of the arm where it's less likely to break off. And finally, the last step is to glue on a small plastic portion cup, but glue by itself probably won't keep this on because as the catapult is fired, that glue bond can be weakened and eventually the cup can fly off. So in addition to the glue, also get a long piece of masking tape and wrap it onto the cup from the underside of the catapult arm. Okay, we are ready to fire, and the best technique to get a good launch is to strike downward on the short end of the catapult arm with your fingers and follow through. If you start by resting your hand on the short end of the catapult arm and then push down, it's not going to go as far. This is because it takes time for your hand to start accelerating, so you may not get as forceful of a launch. My projectile of choice are these foam cubes. They're dense enough to go a satisfying distance, but they also won't break anything. One final note, you can modify the catapult to be powered by a rubber band by doing this. So take the rubber band and loop it around the base using a hitch knot, which looks like this. Pull that tight and then loop the rubber band around this stopping stick right here. Now, when you pull the catapult arm back, the rubber band gets stretched out and it will power the catapult. One rubber band is not nearly as powerful as just striking the catapult, so you may want to add more. So one thing that you can try customizing with this design is the length of the catapult arm. There's a reason why we push on the short end and why the projectiles go in the long end. This is the idea of leverage. So this lever is producing a type of mechanical advantage where the output distance of the projectiles is greater than the input distance. In this example, I'm only pushing down about 2 inches, but the projectiles are being elevated and eventually launched about 7 inches. This means that the plastic cup here is moving over 3 times faster than my hand, which is going to launch the projectiles even farther. You can also look at this from the other way around. If the projectiles were being launched from this end and I had to push down on the long end, you can see that that is not very effective. I have to move my hand a lot just to get a little bit of motion on the other side. Using a lever like this might be useful if I was trying to lift something heavy, because the effort that I'm putting over this entire distance is being concentrated in a smaller distance. But in these catapults, getting a higher velocity at the output is more important than concentrating all of the force over a smaller area. So again, you can experiment with the length of the catapult arm. If the arm was even longer, then when you push down, it might go even faster and shoot the projectiles farther. But with more length comes more weight, so you'd have to put more energy into this end to get the catapult arm moving and then up to speed. And if the catapult arm is really long, then the dowel might break under the force of trying to lift up such a heavy arm. So there's definitely a balance to explore. The other thing to explore are the projectiles. Like I said, I like using these, especially if I'm in a classroom, but smaller and denser projectiles will go farther. So you could try using something like pencil erasers, or you can make an activity out of experimenting with your own custom projectiles by crumpling up balls of foil. Again, it's a balance. If the projectiles are too big and heavy, then it's gonna take too much energy to get them moving. But if they're too small and light, then they're going to get slowed down and eventually stopped early by the air resistance. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.